It's the next day. But let's start. Okay, so another snake that is killed, that is non-venomous and completely harmless, that is often killed for no reason, is the water snake. They are often mistaken for cottonmouths. And I gotta tell you, people in central Oklahoma, there's no cottonmouths. I know people say it all the time. Oh, that's a moccasin. Oh, it's not. It is 100% not if you're in central Oklahoma, unless one escaped the zoo, because they have a very specific habitat range and they live out east in more of the swampy, dense wooded area. So if you're especially like even in the westernmost counties of the central Oklahoma area, there's absolutely no way you're seeing a cottonmouth. Yes, I'm in a new shirt. I switched the shirt back because I looked back at the footage that I had for this video and it was terrible. So we're just gonna start from so. Differences between cottonmouths and water snakes. Water snakes will have patterns. So you have the plain-bellied water snake in this area and you have the diamondback water snake in this area. Both of which have really pretty patterning or stripes or blotches or something like that. So the plain-bellied water snake is going to have dark brown blotches along the length of its body, and it's going to be a lighter brown for the main part. It's going to have a plain white belly. Cottonmouth is going to be solid black almost 90% of the time, unless you have a weird morph. 90% of the time, it's going to be solid black or gray. The diamondback water snake is another species of water snake, harmless water snake, that lives in the central Oklahoma area, in all the counties I mentioned earlier. It is green-ish. It's kind of a gross green color, but it's still green, and it has black, kind of zigzaggy, blotchy patterns going up and down the sides. The belly's not going to be plain. It's going to actually have speckles or little stripes going up and down it. It's going to have kind of redder eyes, but both pupils on the water snake Neurodia species, the harmless species, are going to be rounded pupils. Right? That cottonmouth is going to have those slits. That cottonmouth is going to have those cat eyes, like most vipers do. But you can't use that as an indicator every time because there are some harmless species that do have that. They're just not going to be in any of these videos because they don't live here in central Oklahoma. Now, in order to be more informative this one, I am going to explain to you the differences between the head of a water snake and the head of a cottonmouth. I understand that water snakes will flatten their head out and it will make it seem triangular when they are frightened or stressed. The cottonmouth will always have a triangular head. That's because it has venom glands that are stored in the back. It kind of makes it look puffy. Kind of makes it look like I have a puffy head. That's where its venom is actually being stored. They use the venom to kill their prey mainly, but also to defend themselves. And those water snakes will not have that. Like, if you're not threatening it, it will just be a rounded head. It will look like the head just blends into the neck. The head will just blend into the neck and then go down the body. With a cottonmouth, there's a distinct place where the head is separated from the neck and body. Cottonmouths are also very, very fat. So the diamondback water snake is also very, very fat. It's a big snake. The cottonmouth is big. The plain belly is long and slender. They don't get that fat. They can get really long. Cottonmouths will not get too long, maybe 3 feet. I mean, I could be wrong about that, but they do get really, really fat like most vipers. The diamondback water snake can get really, really fat. But remember, a thing you can use is the patterning technique to tell the differences. Okay, again, like I've said for almost every video so far, to not confuse things with vipers is the pits. Okay, so those pits are going to be on the upper jaw. It's going to be those extra hole behind the nostrils. Okay, it's going to be on the top jaw. The cottonmouth will have a very white or plain bottom jaw. So you can see that pit up where it's still kind of black. The water snakes do not have that. They have the nostrils and then they have the eyes. There's no extra hole in the middle. Nothing for heat sensing. No pits. Therefore, it's not a pit viper. Okay, so you're probably only going to see both of these species. If you live out east in these counties, there's like a small chance of a cottonmouth. I highly doubt that you'll see a cottonmouth though, because they have a specific range that's farther east in the state. So if there's anyone from East Oklahoma, you're welcome to listen to this. Okay, so you're gonna see both water snakes and you're gonna see cottonmouths if you live near water. These species are aquatic. They eat fish, they eat frogs, they eat things that live near the water. So they need to have some sort of water source where they live. They just need to have water. Okay, so you're most likely gonna see these snakes if there's anywhere like a lake near you. Like, for example, there's a lake right there. See a lot of water snakes at that lake. You know what I've never seen at that lake though? A cottonmouth. A lot of water snakes though, because those water snakes will eat the fish from that lake. They will eat the small turtles from that lake. They will eat maybe small turtles. I'm actually not sure about that. Don't quote me. And they will also eat the frogs from that lake. Okay, the last way that I found is super easy to distinguish a water snake from a cottonmouth. Keep in mind, these two snakes are two of the hardest kinds of snakes to differentiate from one another. Okay, they're so similar in their behavior, because water snakes are mean. They're not nice snakes, like a lot of the other non-venomous snakes around here. They're just mean, they look dangerous, they flatten their heads out to be triangular. So it's kind of hard to tell when they're stressed out. So that's why the triangular head technique is not the best technique to use. But this is a really easy way to identify them that I found works almost every time. Okay, so on each snake, both types of water snakes, the diamondback and the plain-bellied that are in this area, you've also got some more species out like super far east, like the broadband and the midland slash northern water snake. But what I found is that on the lip scales of both of these non-venomous water snakes, they have little, I don't know, stripes of color in between each scale. You'll see this in garter snakes too. There's gonna be a dark coloration in between the lip scales. And the cottonmouths, the lip scales, they're not separated by anything. And it's just the same color all the way around. There's not gonna be any specific color lines. It's just gonna be a plain lower jaw. All right, that should be good for these aquatic snakes. Hopefully this was helpful. Even if you do see a cottonmouth somehow, don't kill it. It's important for the ecosystem. Watch for snakes out there. Don't kill them. They might seem scary, but they're actually really helpful.